morning, I would like to make an announcement nga the sermon that will be preached will be a hard conversation. This is something that we don't want to. This is something that we don't wish to. Pero mga igsoon, sometimes we need confrontation. Sometimes we need hard conversation. Makainomdom ko, may ngunagay na si Pastora sa ako. Pastor, bang, istorya sa ta. Agoy, sana ni. Muna yung mga hard conversation, mga confrontation. No? I remember the music team, magmay ngunagay ko, emergency meeting ta, wala na. Lukso-lukso na ilang dughan. Unsa na pugkaha ni. Because we don't want confrontation. We don't want hard conversation. So karong buntag, our theme will be Jesus will cost you everything. I mean everything. Everything that you have, it will cost you. Kung gusto ka musunod kang Kristo. And our text is found in Luke chapter 14, verses 25 to 27. Gibasa na kaganina sa atong first reading ni Pastora Jane ang atong text. Pero ito ang sublion sa pagbasa. A large crowd was following Jesus. He turned around and said to them, "If you want to be my disciple, you must be, by comparison, hate everyone else. Your father and mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, yes, even your own life. Otherwise, you cannot be my disciple." This is the price that at stake, no? When you want to follow Jesus. And in verse 27, "If you do not carry your own cross and follow me, again, you cannot be my disciple." Samtang nagasunod kining mga followers ni Jesus Christ, he asked them this very important, critical, and siguro may ngong kung a difficult question. Do you really want to become my disciple? In this confrontation, nanguta na si Jesus Christ, "Kinsa sa inyo gusto mahimo na kong disipulo?" Who wants to become my disciple? Really want to become my disciple? So makita nato dinhi that Jesus is not looking for a church member. Jesus is not looking for a believer. Jesus is looking for a disciple. It's one thing to become a church member. It's one thing to become a believer. But it's something to become a disciple. Can you say amen? And the price is too much. If you want to become a disciple, mga igsoon, we live in the era of convenience, no? Remote controls everywhere. Sa una, kung mag-on ka sa TV, imog yung duulon. Karon, imo na lang kabliton, mubuto. Mu-on na din ang TV. No? Sa una, ang suga, mubumba-bumba ka pa itong Petromax, aron musiga. Karon, imo na lang kabliton sa bumbong, buto na po ang suga. Ultimo CR, karon, remote control na. Paghinlo sa imong kuan, piyong-piyong na lang ka. Nanay, maghinlo sa imong ano, di ba? Nana, di ba? Nanay sensor. Pag mag-ihi ka, di nanay mo kinanglan pos buton mo, agas lang, we live in the era of convenience. And sometimes, this conveniency nakakrip in na sa mga kasimbahanan. We have a lot of convenient Christianity. Gusto ta mga lagad sa Ginoo in our terms, sa atong gusto nga pacing. Lord, mga lagad ko, Lord, pero mo ni ang akong schedules. Mga lagad ko, Lord, pero mo ni akong mga conditions. Pwede ko mga lagad, Lord, pero diri ra ko kutob. We have our own terms, no? Gusto tag Kristohanon nga sayon nga pagka-Kristohanon. Gusto ta mga lagad ka ng sayon nga pagpangalagad. Gusto ta mga lagad ka ng convenient nga pagpangalagad. Muni ang nag-creep in sa mga kasimbahanan karon mga igsoon. But following Jesus is not a life of convenience. It is costly. Walay nagsaad nga ang Kristyanismo is a garden of roses. Walay nagsaad nga ang Kristyanismo is a garden of roses. Pastor Abi, maguna kong bed of roses? Dili. Guns and roses, pwede. Nang wala kasabot sa kuan, wala na sila kailangan sa ng guns and roses. Itong mga Metallica na, mga batch na sa Metallica, mga Scorpio, no? Mga, that's a band. Muna nagkanta sa Sweet Child of Mine. Umana mo ang mga gimmick-gimmick sa una, no? Dili bid of roses, guns and roses, pwede. Walay nagsaad nga kanang muning lisod, no? Kanang we thought nga pag makristohanon ka it's a nice thing. Pag mahimong kristohanon ka it's a funny thing. Kung mahimong kristohanon ka it's an easy thing. But when you are in the Christian life, you were amazed. Dili mo diingon ani, di abi manakog malipayon ka kung kristohanon ka, abi manakog sayon kung kristohanon ka, abi manakog kanang abundansya kung kristohanon ka. And that is why Jesus is asking them, do you really want to become a disciple? Di nga rin mong katapad, gusto gyud ka mahimong disipulo ni Kristo? Sure na jud ka? Because once you will enlist in the discipleship program of Jesus Christ, there is no turning back. Umoni ang confrontation na gihatang ni Jesus Christ sa iyong mga followers, do you really want to become my disciple? Because it's not easy. It's difficult. Mga igsoon, lisod ang biyahing langit. Ngano na kayong kung lisod ang biyahing langit? Si Kristo mismo nagpamatod, ingon siya, sigpit ug lisod ang dalan paingon ngadto sa kinabuhi. Sigpit ug dutay lang ang gusto mo adto ana nga dalan. Dutay lang ang gusto mo pili ana nga dalan because he wanted conveniency. Munang dutay lang ang nakakaplag ug tinud-anay nga kinabuhi. Mo ning giingon ni Kristo. Mga igsoon, libre ang kaluwasan. Amen. Pero ang journey paingon sa kaluwasan, it's so costly. The price is too high. Muna mga igsoon, when you choose to follow Jesus, you have to be sigurado na ka. You have to be sure that you really want to become a disciple. Pare po sa pastoral ministry ko, gusto ko ka mamastor? Dili dula-dula ang pagpamastor. Dili ibog-ibog ang pagpamastor. Kasagaran karon mga young people, gignan lang sa iyang silingan, oy pasturuno lagi ka doon, iskwila nag-Bible school. Lo and behold, wala nakagraduate sa Bible school. Because they think, libre man ang i-invite ka sa Bible school. But when you submit yourselves in the seminary, it's so costly. You have to wake up early in the morning, 4 o'clock in the morning, mag-devotional. Every 4 o'clock in the morning, matulog ka 1 o'clock in the evening, in the morning again. 1 o'clock in the morning because you have to study the lessons. Yeah, grabe ba yan ang mong standards sa seminary kay murag University of the Subrapat, 28 units good. Asa ka kita na? Wabot pa yung 31 units ang uban? Grabe na kayo? Asa ka kita na nga standard? Only in the Philippines lang na. Para rago namin yung ko sa imuha, faith, paiskwilahon ta kalibre. Ako tanan, pamasahi, kaunin mo ako tanan. But it doesn't mean nga free sa yon ang pag-eskwila faith, di ba? Tungod kay gilibrita ka, maningkamot jug ka mag-eskwela. Amen. Why? Because libre. Maupo ni ang kaluwasan, libre ang kaluwasan, but it's not cheap. It's so costly and the price is too high. Kung naa ka na diha sa journey sa kaluwasan, you have to pay the price. There is a price to be paid. Amen? Mga igsoon, in verse 25, a large crowd, everybody say large crowd. I believe thousands of crowds, so multitudes of people are following Jesus. So sa panahon ni Kristo, sikat-sikat naging si Kristo. Daghay naga-follow sa iya, daghay fans niya sa iyang Facebook account, sa iyong Twitter account, sa iyong YouTube account, there's a lot of followers. No? Grabe. No? And then, muna yung among gusto mga pastor. Kanang daghang membro. Muna yung among gusto, kanang daghan maminaw sa among wali. Pero kang Kristo, lahi. Sa iyong nakita niya ang hugpong sa katilingban, hugpong sa mga katauhan, He asked them, do you really want my disciple? Because Jesus don't want quantity, He wants quality. Can you say amen? Sayon mag-uban-uban sa crowd, no? Kaya kayo na yung managan? Managan ang tao, apil na po kang dagan. Bisag, wala kasabot sa ginagangan, dagan na po kang apil. Because it's too easy to blend in the crowd. Can you say amen? Asa sila, dagan na po kang apil, makakabalo sa ilang ginaganan. Kita mo nang sa kanang mga pranks, no? Dagan na po kang apil, wala kasabot sa ginaganan. Mga iksoon mo ni, no? Kung dagang kag membro, kung sadya imong simbahan, dagay mag-invite si mga speaker o lecturer. And you will be invited and you will be asked the question, Pastor, yun sa nimo pagpadaghan ang imong membro. Wow. Ganahan kay Miani. Adik kay Miani. In fact, gikorek ko sa Ginoo, nang usay mo yun ko nga, asa naman ang mga membro, anong gamay raman? Ingon na Ginoo, asa man nagikan, Pastor? Sa ato, mamuwali na kagdaghan imong membro. I was corrected by God. I was kanang rebuked by God. Asa nagikan? Amen. So, mga igsoon, during sa time ni Jesus Christ, daghan siyag mga fans, daghan siyag mga followers, but when He asked them, do you really want my, to become a disciple? Because following me will cost you greatly. Igsoon, kung pagkakasugod, ayaw na lang sugod. Pero kung nakasugod ka na, there's no turning back. Sadyang mingon siya nga, if you follow me, these are the terms. Ug sugod atong panahon na in John 66, at this point of time, many of His disciples turned away and deserted Him. So nang lakaw og nangaon og desert. Nag-break lang sila. Nag-break lang. So, siguro nag-Bible study gikan, nag-break sila. Nangawas lang Mingo float siguro, deserted. Daghay mitalikod, mibiya kang Kristo. Mauni ang kinabuhing Kristohanon, mga igsoon. Mga igsoon, Jesus wants followers, not fans. Jesus Christ wants quality, not quantity. Jesus Christ wants commitment, not convenience. Jesus Christ wants a disciple, not a church member. So these are the requirements nga gilid out ni Jesus Christ when you want to become a disciple. Number one, if you want to be my disciple, you must, by comparison, hate everyone. Everybody say hate everyone. Kaligut-guti ang tanan. Kaya? Hate your wife. Hate your children. Hate your mother and father. And hate, are you ready for this one? And hate even yourself. Now again, question. Do you really want to be, do you really want to become a disciple? This is the price. Requirements number one, supreme devotion to Christ. You must hate everyone else. Pastor, dili ba siya conflict, Pastor? Di ba ningon, God is love, and then ningon siya nga, you have to love your brothers and sisters, you have to love your parents, you have to respect them. Yung anong din, Pastor, ningon si Jesus Christ, you have to hate them. Hate your parents, hate your brothers, hate your sisters, and hate yourself. Di ba siya nag-conflict, Pastor, sa teaching ni Jesus Christ? Mga igsoon, that hate, it means loving them less. It's not loveless, it's loving them less. Buti pa sabot, tanan nga naa sa imuha, mas jutay ang imong gugma sa ila kung iatbang na kang Kristo. So everything that is in you, kung si Kristo na ang kaatbang, you have to love Christ more than anything and anyone in your life. That's the meaning of hate everyone else. Kung si Kristo na ang kaatbang sama kang Abraham, pag-ingon ni Jesus Christ, pag-ingon sa Ginoo kang Abraham, you have to offer your son. Dapat dili na kang maglibog kinsa ang imong pilion if you are a disciple. Abraham loved his child, amen. He prayed for the child. He is waiting for the child. But when God asked him, are you willing to offer your child? Sige po ni Abraham, without any hesitation, he offered his child. Why? Because he is a disciple of Christ. Walay pagdumili, you know what to do if you are a disciple. You have to love Jesus more than your parents. You have to love Jesus more than your friends. You have to love Jesus more than your work. You have to love Jesus more than your treasure. You have to love Jesus more than your talent. Are you ready for this one? You have to love Jesus more than yourself. That is the cost of being a disciple. Mga igsoon, this love is not just loving Jesus a little bit more. No, it's not that kind of love. Lord, I will love you more than, a little bit more than my parents, than my job, than my treasure, than my brothers and sisters. No! This love that we are talking, it's too high. Dili ni nga, muna imong gugma sa Ginoo, muna imong gugma sa uban. No! Muna imong gugma sa Ginoo, muna imong gugma sa uban. That when you consider your love to yourself, it's considered hate. Tungod sa imong gugma sa Dios, muragi kaligot-gutan na nimo imong kaugalingon. Tungod sa imong nakong gugma sa Ginoo, halos di na nimo mahinumduman ang imong kaugalingon. Mauni ang buti pasabot of hating yourself. Because of that great love that you have for Jesus, you have kanang less love for yourself. That when you look at to yourself, you are actually hating yourself. You don't want to fall yourself anymore. Amen? Question again, do you really want to become a disciple of Christ? The price is too high. The price is too big. Manayin ko kang pastora, lahi mangugupang magbuhat ko gwali, everything na ma-learn ako, ipabuto gidin ako, I'm so excited to share it to others. Balag, sabaan sila, bahala na sila. Kung amang, disod gyud kay ning mahimukan disipulo ni Kristo, no? No wonder why nganong sa kadaghan nagsunod kang Kristo, dusi lang ikabok ang disipulo. Sa dusi na pagi buang, murag lubi nga buang, no? Sa dusi ka, sa dusi nga saging sa usa ka sipi na pagi butikulon. Kadaghan nagsunod, thousands of people, and I asked myself, how about sa among church we are only 80 church members? Na kaya isa Lord? Na kaya isa? Even pastors, it's so hard to qualify to become a disciple. Bisag mga pastor. Then I ask myself, Maynard, do you really want to become a disciple? Can you love me more than your wife? Can you love me more than your talent? Can you love me more than your need? Can you love me more than anyone and anything in your life? The price is too high. Lord, have mercy. Ingon ana, kalayo ang gugma nato sa Ginooy compare sa atong gugma sa atong kaugalingon. Your love to God is this one and your love to yourself is that one. Muna, nga kung mupili ka, there is no comparison. Kabalo na kadaan unsa ang imong pilion. Amen? If you are a disciple or if you want to become a disciple, you know exactly what to do. It's your choice. And then, ingon si Jesus Christ, if you cannot do this one, you cannot be my disciple. You can be in the crowd, you can still be a believer, you can still be a Christian, but you cannot be a disciple. The problem of Christianity today is we are staying too much, no, in the level of a believer. We don't transition from the level of believer to a disciple. Take heart, mga igsoon, be comforted. Dili ba ni automatic nga pagbudawat ka ng Kristo, automatic disciple na rin ka, you can love yourself less? No. It's a process. It's a long journey. It's a lifetime journey. And I know one day, mulingi ka sa imong likod, makaingon ka, Lord, salamat kayo. May tubo na gidepog ko sa akong pagkakristohan. Because it's walking daily with the Lord. It's continual kanang continual rejection of yourself. It's continual denial of yourself. And you will grow and grow and grow and grow. That's the meaning of the first requirement, self supreme devotion. Loving God is not just about feelings. Loving God is not just about the heart. Loving God is all about you. It's not just less of me, more of God. Correction. None of me, all of God. All of me loves all of God. Na 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 na. All of me, not just my heart. Akong pankreas, akong batikulon, akong tiil, akong kamot, akong mata, ilong, tiil, baba, ngipon, everything that is found in me will be loving God. That's the meaning of the word supreme devotion. I will ask the question once again. Do you really want to become a disciple of Jesus? Number two, verse 27. If there's supreme devotion in verse 27, and if you do not carry your own cross, everybody say, carry your own cross, and follow me again, you cannot be my disciple. The second term of Jesus Christ is self-denial. Number one, supreme devotion. Second, self-denial. I-explain ka ganun ni Pastora Jane, it's dying to yourself slowly. Every day, you have to die. It's a high level self-denial. Dili na ibot ipasabot ka kanang nag-deny lang ka sa die. Di lang ko mga umukawang karong paniod to. It's not like that nga denial. Dili lang ka nang nanguyab ka nga wak kagisugot. It's not that kind of denial. Dili lang nang nag-appointment ka din wak kagisipot. It is not like that denial. It's a high level of denial. It's actually looking at yourself that you are dead. The moment that you receive Christ, you are already dead. Patay ka na diha sa imong kaugalingon. It means kalimtan nimo ang imong kaugalingon. Ang self-centered nga tao, mayingon ko sa inyo ha, pasalamat mo, nagiwalihan mo, that self-centeredness. Self-denial, pasalamat ko, gitagaan kong chance and opportunity sa Ginoo nga makawali sa inyo. That self-denial. Self-centeredness, pasalamat mo, membro ko sa church ninyo. Self-denial, pasalamat ko sa Ginoo, gitultulan ko sa Ginoo, mahimong membro sa Hope of Glory. That self-denial. Kalimtan nimo ang imong kaugalingon. It's not about me. You have to let go of me. Lingay mo katabad siya, you have to let go of you. If you want to become a disciple, not your dream anymore. Not your wants anymore. Not your desire anymore. Not what I want anymore. If you want to become a disciple, inana katlisod ang requirements to become a disciple of Jesus Christ. Self-denial means none of me, all of God. It's not less of me, more of God. It's none of me. Pagkalisod ba day kaayo mga igsuon? Oh, pagkalabihang lisura gigayo. As I ponder this message that I have made, pagkalisod agiday ginuon, isag pastor, maglisod ani ba? Labi na nga, nagapuyo kita karon sa kalibutan that is glorifying self. We are living in a selfie world. And I don't have to check your account, your Twitter, your YouTube, your Facebook. I don't have to check that one because I believe 7 out of 10, the post is about you. What you want, what you like, what your dream, it's all about you. I know. What we wish, what we don't like, that's how selfish we are. Because we are living in a selfie world. We are actually kanang shaped by the culture of the selfie world. I don't know kung makakita kong post about God sa inyohang Facebook account. Ang uban, pag-deactivate ko, pastor, kaya matintal ko. Pwede man ka din mag-activate, i-post na tanan sa Ginoo. Ayaw pag-posto ka ng dili sa Ginoo. Amen? Amen? Pagkalisod ba dahil mga igsuon? Ang kalibutan, ingon siya, what you want, you will get. Ilihan sila natin mo, maimo na. No. To become a disciple is not like that. Imo bito ng kinabuhi, brad, sister. Enjoy na. Sana. Yulu. Yulu. Yulu ba na? Yo? Ha? Yulu? Muna no? A piece mo na mo? Unsay sign na ng yulu? Gani? Unsay sign na na? Enjoy life because you only live once. Ngunit ang kalibutan. And then, ang mga young people po, yeah. Yeah, tama. Ngunit gusto na to, Kristohanon nga sayon, Kristohanon nga kanang dililisod. Di ta gusto mo matag sayo. Gusto tag sayon. Kanang easy Christianity ba? Hallelujah. Mga igsoon, everything nga naa sa ato, once you enlist yourself in the discipleship program of the Lord Jesus Christ, ang akong kinabuhi, dili na ako. Ang akong panahon, dili na ako. Ang akong treasure, dili na ako. Ang akong talent, dili na ako. Ang tanan nga nasa ako, dili na ako. That's the meaning of the word self-denial. Mga igsoon, paminawa ko ninyo. Listen to me. Dili ka mabuhi hangto dili ka mamatay. There is no resurrection without crucifixion. Tingay mo katapad din siya, mamatay. Unta ka. Patay ka na. Patay ka na. Patay ka na. The moment you receive Jesus Christ, patay ka na. Kinahanglan dunay matapos bago dunay magsugod. Can you say amen? Matapos ang imong daang kinabuhi aron masugdan ang bag-ong kinabuhi. There is no life without death. You have to die in yourself. Jesus will not start until you end. Jesus will not begin until you end. Jesus will not work in your life if you will not die to yourself. That is the meaning of the word self-denial. Makapamuhat lamang ang Dios sa imo kung i-consider nimo nga patay ang imong kaugalingon diha sa Dios. Dili ni pwede mga igsuon nga you disobey the Lord and you still be happy Christian. Dili ni Kristohanon nga you don't have commitment and then you are still be successful in Christian life. No. It is not that way. If you want to become really a disciple, commitment, self-denial, supreme devotion. Pagkalisod na rin na, Pastor, lisod. Jesus will cost you everything. Nya, musuway pa mo. Suway pa mo? Katong wa pa kasuway, ayaw na. Pero kung naa naman ka din, mo na ni. There's no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. It's your choice. Kung naana ka din sa enlisting sa discipleship program ni Jesus Christ, and then you disobey, you will not be happy. May pag wala na lang ka nag-enlist diri, nag-enjoy na lang ka sa kalibutan. Di ka malipay. Why? Because you are part now of the program. And again, you cannot be happy and still disobey the Lord. It's impossible. It's impossible. Mga igsoon, Jesus will cost you everything. Sigurado ko, it will hurt you. It will bleed you. And maybe it will kill you following Jesus. Si Kristo nag-antos dido. Si Peter nag-antos dido. Si Pablo nag-antos dido. Tanang nagsunod kang Kristo, nag-antos. And then you want, pwede pa sa, di lang mag-antos? Asa na nga, napa na nga Christianity, mara gusto ko diha, Brad. Asa na nga Christianity, kayo, kinsa inyo ang, kuhan diha, kayo musunod ko, nanindot na, nga Christianity. Amen. Walay Kristohanon sa Bible nga wala nag-antos. Jesus Christ actually did not come to abolish suffering. He did not come to erase suffering. He came to show to us, to model to us, that in spite of the suffering, you can still conquer. Why? Because He conquered the world. Gipakita ni Kristo nga bisan tinuod luyo sa mga pagsulay, you can still be a faithful and committed believer of the Lord Jesus Christ. Bisan taliwala sa kalibutan na puno of temptation, you can still stand still and never be tempted. Gipakita na ni Kristo. Even everybody is doing it, you can still say no because Jesus did not do it. Because He is our example, He is our model. Can you say amen? Gipakita niya nga kaya nato buntugon ng kalibutan because He conquered it. He exemplified, He demonstrated it, He showed it. Nga pwede gid ay mulahutay diha sa mga pag-antos. Jesus will cost you everything. In John chapter 6, verse 66, at this point, many of His disciples turned away and deserted Him. Verse 67, then Jesus said to the 12, do you also want to go away? Dosin lang na bilin. Daggan kayo nagsunod-sunod. Paglingi ni Kristo, humayag sulti, muni ang prisyo. Do you really want to become a disciple? Inahinay. Inahinay. Paglingi ni Jesus Christ, dosin lang kabuok ang nabilin. And He asked them, how about you? Do you also want to go away? And Peter, I love Peter. I like Peter. Ang hambugiro nga Pedro. Salamat ang aning panahon na He is right. Ang sitawagan na kanang kuan ba kanang kuan jud kanang gusto gid siya kanang sitawagan na. Agresibo nga Pedro. Gusto gid siya kanang siya maguna. But this time He is right. Salamat na lang aning panahon na tama si Pedro. Unsay tubag ni Pedro? But Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom shall we go? Lord, kung muundang mig pagpangalagad sa imo, asa man mi paingon? Because we knew that you are the source of eternal life. We knew that you are the Son of the living God. If we will stop following you, asa man mi mo adto? Managing una ko sa inyo ha, there is no turning back. Asa man mo adto? Asa man mo adto? Wala na talang choice. Puslan man nabasa na ta, ligo na lang ta. Puslan man naligo na ka, panabo na lang. Puslan man nanabo na ka, pag-ilis na lang. Puslan man ilis na ka, pagamit na lang. Amen. Amen. Pagamit na lang. Verse 69. Also, we have come to believe and know that you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. We believe, Lord, that you are the Son of the living God. Mga igsoon, we give up what is temporary. We give up what is temporary in exchange with what is eternal. I-give up na to ang mga temporary things in exchange in eternal things. That's what we are doing in here. Moingunta nga, pagkalisuda man ay pastor, yes. Manigingon ako sa inyo ha, nga kanang delayed gratitude. Tinood, we will not enjoy delayed gratification. Correction, not gratitude. Delayed gratification. Tinood, dili pa ka mag-enjoy kayo karon sa imong pagkakristohanon. But one day, God will vindicate you. God will prove to you na ang imong decision nga magpabilin sa Ginoo is right. And it will not happen if you will not stay. Paano mo ma-prove nga tinood pag ining Matthew 6:33, Lord? Tinood na! It's not just a cliche. It's not just memory verse. Seek ye first. I know you have been battered and bothered sa mga needs kinabuhi. But believe me, it's not the solution. What you are thinking? No. Kneel down before God. Ask the Lord, God, lead me, guide me what to do. Pray. From the heart. God. Kabalo ko left and right ang mga panginahanglan. Grabe ang inflation. Ang increase sa inflation, mas taas sa increase atong sweldo. But Matthew 6:33 is our comfort. Seek ye first the kingdom of the Lord and all these things shall be added unto you. Ako buhi pa man jud ko. Gracias sa Ginoo, buhi pa si Pastor Raji. Kami ang mga buhing testamento that God will provide. Testimony. Ulaw man i-testimony, no? Pero okay lang. Alin ako malangin sa akong asawa, kay testimony man naman yung personal. Before ko nag-resign sa DepEd, there is no promise of support sa church. And during the time, I am receiving only 7,000 pesos a month. Kabalo mo pila akong gibaylo nga sweldo, mag full time. We exchange almost 50,000 a month with 7,000 a month. And that's, okay mo, that's a crazy things. Crazy thing, no? So, nga gibaylo ni mo nang, di ba, kayo ka nga, that's foolishness. Pero mo igingon sa ko sa Ginoo, you have to serve me. Kisa ba di bad look? Kisa ba'y dili mo praning? Na ako'y bayroon ng sakyanan, 12,000 naman, then I'm receiving only 7,000. Sa sakyanan palang wala na. Mga bills pa sa balay. Sa man, di may mga on, kaon may bunot. Bisa pag tinapa-tinapa, nudulos-nudulos mo gasto ka po kagwarta. But after 6 years, look at us. Buhi pa man lagi gihapon. Malipayon ng alagad sa Ginoo. Amen? last year, naimpas ang sakyanan. Salamat sa church. Nag-i-bless sa Ginoo, aron tabangan niyo naimpas ang sakyanan. Praise the Lord. God is not a liar. Kabalo mo, you are in frustration sometimes, Lord. Pero mag kinay mong sadi man may hitabo sa akong kinabuhi, may hitabo na, just wait. It will happen. Amen. It will happen. Just stay on the course. Pabilin sa lumba. Stay in the course. And you will experience every promised na gisaad sa Ginoo sa panid sa kasulatan. Can you say amen? Mga igsoon, Jesus is worth the cost. Dili ka magmahay mga lagad ka sa Ginoo igsoon. Jesus is worth the cost. To have Jesus is the greatest joy that you will ever have. To have Jesus is the greatest treasure that a person will ever have. To have Jesus, to walk with Him is the greatest journey a person you will ever have. And to love Jesus is the greatest love that a person can ever have. Jesus is worth the cost. And I want you to love Him completely. I am persuading you to love Him completely. I am persuading you to serve Him committedly. Ginaagnita mo, ginadasig ta mo, gina-challenge ta mo, serve the Lord with gladness. Serve the Lord with commitment. Love the Lord with all of your heart. This is my job as a preacher, to convince you to believe on His word. Not on my words, but on the words of the Lord. Jesus is worth the cost. Amen? Palakpakan nato ang Ginoo. And before I will end, mga igsoon, ang simbahan is not your destination. Ang simbahan is your gasoline station. Everybody say, gasoline station. Moani mo diri aron mutubil. Di mo moani diri aron magstay. No. Ang imong trabaho, muna imong destination. Ang imong negosyo, muna imong destination. Ang imong skwilahan, muna imong destination. Ang inyong pamilya, muna imong destination. Kabalo ko dagay pamilya pa diri nga wala pa di asti ilan sa Ginoo. That's your destination. Once what you have heard in here, what you have learned in here, tell your family. This is your gasoline station. This is your gas station. You come in here to fill up. Aron matubilan ka, aron mapuno ka, ug moadto ka sa imong destination aron ipabuto. No. Students, go to your school. Not to find love, but to share the love. Workers, go to your job. Not to find the blessing, not to work for the blessing, but to share the blessing that you have. Young people, go to your friends. Not to look for a boyfriend or girlfriend, but to look for his souls. Church is your gasoline station. It's not our destination. Do you really want to become a disciple of Jesus Christ? God bless us all.